Welcome to Kampala Bible Revelation Church, located at Makerere 1, Okubira Zone. Pastor Hanning Mutukiriza and other servants of God welcome you to a ministry based on the Word of God. We have a covenant with God for placement and multiplication according to Ezekiel 37 verse 26 to 28. Welcome to our Sunday services, which impact believers with transformational revelations from the Word of God. Our Thursday midweek service is a series of teachings equipping believers with practical skills from the Word of God. Testimonies of God's goodness abound. You can also join our Doers of the Word Bible Institute, where God's children have been ground into God's Word and empowered with a practical approach to transformation, both spiritually and physically, totally free of charge. We are located at Makerere 1, Mukubira Zone, near Makerere Business Institute, along Sapalokagwa Road. You are welcome.
Families on God's wings. Bless the name of Jesus. At the same time, says the Lord, will I be the God of all the families of Israel, and they shall be my people. What a promise. What a promise. Bless his holy name. What is it about families? Do you know that there are some people seated here and they don't love their families? Do you know that they are here? Someone said, why is it my family that we always have problems? Why not your family? Get over it. Every family has problems. So you are not unique. You are just common and normal, just like anyone else. And stop grumbling before the Lord. Why my family? Now someone is complaining. Why am I the only child of my mother? Why not? You're not the first one. There are so many children when they are the only one of their mother. Get over it and begin to grab the promises of God. Bless the name of Jesus. Someone is complaining, our family, every time it's our family, they're bewitching our family. Why shouldn't they bewitch your family? There's nothing strange about that. They bewitch all of us. They bewitch all of us and we never pray about it. My auntie cast me, so what? Did you bless her? Did you remember to bless her? For he said, bless whoever curses you, because that's the end of his curse. There is no family without a problem on this planet. Not even the first family of Adam and Eve. In fact, the first murder that took place, it was not between a thief, a robber, and someone they were robbing from. They were brothers from the same family, and there were only two in that family, and one killed the other. You are still safe. As long as you are alive, you are still safe. As long as you are alive, you are still safe. Stop grumbling about your family. That other family is very rich. You don't know that family. Leave it alone. Better eat your greens and posho. I'm serious. And stop complaining about their meat and rice, which they throw out as leftover, because you don't know them. In Genesis chapter 1, Genesis chapter 1 and verse 28, bless his holy name. We can even begin from verse 27. So God created man in his own image, in the image of God created he him, male and female created he them. And God blessed them. And God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply, be wingy, in other words. And replenish the earth and subdue. How would they replenish the earth without wings? How would they go places? How would they fly from the north to the south, east to the west, or even at the center without wings? Bless his whole name. And subdue it and have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the fowl of the air and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. In other words, everything began well at the beginning. Everything began well. God created this beautiful family and blessed it. Bless his holy name. It is in Genesis chapter 3 that we really hate every word we read from there. When the first family fell, because the tempter came and tempted them, and they bought his temptation, And that first family fell. And when that first family fell, everything fell apart. You know the scriptures. Bless his holy name. Only one thing that struck me here, that by the time they fell, they had no child. But they were married. But they had, I don't know why they were taking long. He said, what is it? Why didn't they have children? You know. But by the time they fell, in Genesis chapter 3, they had no children. So are you still surprised that when Jesus was coming, he looked for a couple that was just married, and before they had children, Jesus came in? Because he was answering to the fall of the first couple when they had no children. So you can say that Jesus came with the family on his mind. Bless the name of Jesus. Jesus came to this earth with the family on his mind. That's why he looked for a family, because in Matthew chapter 1, Matthew 1:18, now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise. When as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, have you seen that? Before they came together. Just like Adam and Eve, before they had a child, they fell on sin. Before they came together, Jesus came in. So Jesus came with family on his mind. Jesus came with family on his mind. Well, the Bible respects your individual rights, but God has family on his mind. God has family on his mind. So he spoke to Joseph. So, he spoke to Mary, he spoke to Joseph, prepared them, and then Jesus came. When Jesus came, had he gone on with this family? This family had something he could not explain. They used to ask him, where is your father? And he just used to look at them. I'm talking about Jesus. They used to ask him, where is your father? And he could just look at them. Then finally he said, they said to him, you are a bastard. Because he never showed them. Then they said, show us your father. Who is your father? When Jesus came, he made a family on God's wings. In Matthew chapter 12, go with me to Matthew chapter 12. When Jesus came, he made a family. Matthew 12:46. While he had talked to the people, behold, his mother and his brethren stood without, desiring to speak with him. Then one said unto him, behold, thy mother and thy brethren stand without, desiring to speak with thee. But he answered and said unto him that told him, who is my mother? Hey, what had happened to Jesus? Who is my mother and who are my brethren? And he stretched forth his hand toward his disciples and said, behold, my mother and my brethren. Was Jesus joking? For whosoever shall do the will of my Father which is in heaven, the same is my brother and sister and mother. And where is the Father? Don't keep quiet. Where is the Father? In heaven, of course. Of course, in heaven. Would have said it in a split of a second. What was Jesus doing here? He was creating another family. And in this family, whoever will do the will of his father shall be his brother, his sister, and his mother. So when Jesus came, he created another family. Because Jesus was not joking. He meant everybody he said. Heaven and earth will pass away, but these ones will never pass away. So Jesus brought into this world another family. And this is the family on God's wings. If you believe it, shout a better amen. Amen. You can even put those hands together for the Lord. So what happened to his mother and his brethren? I don't know. I don't know what happened. Because from here we go to another chapter, so I don't know what happened to his brethren and his mother. But right here, Jesus said there is another family, which you need to know. Everyone that will do the will of my Father. In other words, everyone who will believe my word. Every believer is family of God. And you may be the only one who is born again there. I don't care. Because of you, your whole family is included in that family. Amen. You believe that? Shout a good amen.
Amen.
This must be the family on God's wings. Let me show you. Go with me to Matthew 23. Matthew 23 and verse 37. These were the words of Jesus and said, O Jerusalem, Jerusalem, thou that killest the prophets and stonest them which are sent unto thee, how often would I have gathered thy children together, even as a what? A hen gathers her chickens under her wings, and ye would not. Oh, I'm willing. I'm willing. Gather me as a hen gathers her chickens under her wings. As for me, I'm willing. Are you willing? Say you're willing. Say it again, you're willing. I'm the family on God's wings. How can he gather me under and he cannot take me over? You see, when he said, all those who will do the will of the Father, those are the ones who are willing, those are the ones who are gathered under the wings of Jesus. He said, Jerusalem, I surely came purposely to gather you as a hen gathers her chicks and her wings, and you don't want. And by the way, he was crying. You remember when he was on that donkey and he looked at Jerusalem and he cried and said, You cannot receive me. I've come with God's wings and you don't want to take them. Lord, I'm willing to take your wings. Take me on your wings. Take my whole family on your wings. I'm willing, I'm willing, I'm willing, I'm willing. So when Jesus came, he made a family that is on God's wings. Thank you, Jesus. Things are going to happen in your family, which have never happened before. Even on that village, they will say, we don't know what is happening to that family. Ever since this year began, everything is going faster than ever before. They will even see occasions happening in your home, good occasions and happiness and joy. If you believe, shout a good amen. And some people will testify, you say, for the first time, they will say, for the first time, they will say, for the first time, it's happening in this family. If you believe, shout a good amen.
Amen.
If you believe, shout a good amen.
Amen.
I want to let you know that Jesus came with family on his mind. And that was very serious. He did not only created a family, which was on God's wings, when he said, those who do the will of the Father are now my brothers and sisters and mother. And that was serious. And then he put that family on his wings, bless his holy name, to fly. And in the night he covers you under his wings. As if that was not enough, Jesus came with family on his mind and he proved it. Now, if you are anointed and heavily anointed, if you happen to be heavily anointed, if you happen to be heavily anointed and you heard the voice of God tell you to go out and heal the sick and cleanse the lepers and raise the dead and cast out devils, what would you do first? You ask me. You ask me what I would do first, and I'm going to tell you. Ask me. Come on. Thank you. I would print big posters. I mean huge. When I have the anointing like the one that Jesus had. Well, don't misunderstand me. Bless his holy name. And I'll print those posters all over. I'll print many, many posters and pin them all over Kampala saying, "Welcome the great prophets." And the first day of service, only those with the dead are welcome to the grounds. I don't know about you, but if it were me, the first miracle I would do would be to raise the dead so that the people may know. What was Jesus' first miracle? He turned water into wine where? Why at a wedding? What? Because of family. Because of family. It was family first on his mind. That's why he performed the first miracle at a family, on a wedding. By the way, your wedding is blessed to hear this. He will turn water into wine. Shout aloud, amen. Jesus. Now, look, with all this anointing and the Holy Spirit, don't forget he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights. The guy was from a long fast. And the anointing was just splashing all over the place. How can I choose in the whole world to go to attend a wedding reception and turn water into wine as my first miracle? For what? That was a signature that he came to fix the family. That amen is weak. He will sign on your family today. He will sign on your family today. Do you see the blessings on them? Why in the whole world would I go to a wedding reception? Jesus came with family on his mind. And God loves your family. Whether they bewitch you or not. Whether they are born again or not. Your father could be a witch doctor. God loves him as much as he loves you, even when you are born again and he's not. God is a family man. God is not a loner. God is a social being and is a family man, and he gets personal when it is family business. Bless his holy name. I said bless his holy name. Some of you came in here this morning without any idea concerning your family. God loves your family. And he wants every one of you born again. That's why he started with you. Pastor, I'm the only one born again. Ah! Stop whining. You are only number one. Number two is coming. And number three is coming. And number four and five and six. And the blind in your family shall see. And the deaf shall hear. And the sick shall be healed. I wish I had a better amen. God has your family on his mind. Begin to mend fences. Bless the name of Jesus. Every time Jesus heard that a family member is sick, he always acted promptly, more than when they told him that your friend is sick. They told him that Lazarus, your friend is sick. He said, okay, I'll come over and see. They said again, your friend is sick. Ah, I'll come over. After that, he said, hey guys, we need to go to Bethany because Lazarus is asleep. And all the disciples said, if he's sleeping, that's a sign of healing. He said, open your eyes, he's dead. Huh? He's dead. Your friend is dead? Let me show you some of the scriptures. Matthew 9:18. Thank you, Jesus. While he spake these things unto them, behold, there came a certain ruler and worshipped him, saying, my what? My daughter is even now dead, but come and lay thy hand upon her, and she shall live. And Jesus arose and followed him And so did his disciples. Did Jesus say anything? He didn't say anything. Once he had this, his family, he just stood up and followed the guy. Let's go. How can she die? Look at Luke 7:12. Luke chapter 7 and verse 12. And see the promptness of Jesus. Now, when he came nigh to the gate of the city, this is the city of Nain, behold, there was a dead man carried out. Wow. The only son of his mother. And he was what? He was dead. And she was a widow. This is too bad news. And much people of the city was with her. And when the Lord saw her, he had compassion on her and said unto her, weep not. God is saying, some families here, stop weeping. And he came and touched the bear, and they that bear him stood still. And he said, young man, wow, I say unto thee, arise. And he that was dead sat up and began to speak. And he delivered him to his mother. Amen. Family business. They shall rise from the dead. Amen. That family business shall rise from the dead. Amen. No one in your family shall die this year in Jesus' name. Amen. Can I hear loud amen? Amen. I want to finish this quickly. Go with me to Luke 19. Luke 19. Luke chapter 19. And verse 7. This was Zacchaeus. You remember Zacchaeus? You know the story? We grew up hearing Zacchaeus, the short man. And when they saw it, they all murmured, saying that he was going to be guest with a man that is a sinner. So the people saw a sinner. People saw a sinner. People see witches. They see witch doctors. They see wizards. That's what people see. They saw a sinner. And Zacchaeus stood and said unto the Lord, when they were not even there, behold, Lord, the half of my goods I give the poor. And if I have taken anything from any man by false accusation, I restore him fourfold. And Jesus said unto him, this day is salvation come to this house, for as much as he also is a son of Abraham. For the Son of Man, what is that? Son of Man? Family, what is that? Family. For the Son of Man is come to seek and save that which was lost. What was that? Family. God is a family man. Bless his holy name. Begin to change the way you think about your family and begin to love every one of them. Bless his holy name. I said, bless his holy name. What I'm talking about is your attitude. It's inside your heart. What do you think about your brothers, your sisters, your relatives, your steps? You know, the stepfather, stepmother, you know, there are families like that. Bless his holy name. And their step-grannies, bless his holy name. There are all kinds of families everywhere. Do you love them or you hate them? And, you know, even when a pastor closed his eyes and said, I see your step-grandmother of your uncle as she was delivering near an anthill. She put a frog on the tip of a lizard, the lizard's head. So there's a spirit of a frog in you which walks like a lizard. Pastors say things, you know. Don't believe it. Refuse to believe it. And believe that God loves your family, including that one who is called a witch. Bless his holy name. By the way, there is nothing that any witch can do to you, because you are God's family. You're doing the will of the Father. So no witch can do anything to you. You don't need any prayer of any man for anything concerning witchcraft. Bless his holy name. Bless the name of Jesus. Well, some of you are new in this place. By the time we came here, there was a big shrine over there. about 100 meters from here. A big shrine there, about 100 meters from here. Big shrine, as big as Muziwazalampanga of the Kasubi tombs. And big vehicles with red number plates used to park there during day. That was serious business. Right over there. We did not even pray single prayer as church. We never fasted. We don't do anything. We simply said, as long as we're here, we are God's family. Someone else has to go. And unless I take you there and I show you, it used to pass through. I mean, they built all around here. I just have to show you. It got burnt, and the one who was inside there lost his mind. And has anyone here lost his mind? Here we are, we're all of us here. Rise to your feet. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Welcome to Kampala Bible Revelation Church, located at Makerere 1, Okubira Zone. Pastor Hanning Mutukiriza and other servants of God welcome you to a ministry based on the Word of God. We have a covenant with God for placement and multiplication according to Ezekiel 37, verse 26 to 28. Welcome to our Sunday services, which impact believers with transformational revelations from the Word of God. Our Thursday midweek service is a series of teachings equipping believers with practical skills from the Word of God. Testimonies of God's goodness abound. You can also join our Doers of the Word Bible Institute, where God's children have been ground into God's Word and empowered with a practical approach to transformation, both spiritually and physically, totally free of charge. We are located at Makerere 1, Mukubira Zone, near Makerere Business Institute, along Sapa Lokagwa Road. You are welcome.